Welcome to the April Sings a Lot podcast. My name is April, and as you might imagine, I sing a lot. In this episode, I'm sharing an excerpt from a live event where I use sing-along switch, a combination of singing with emotional freedom technique, sometimes called tapping. If you're new to tapping or you would like a refresher on the meridian points that we use to tap on, head over to aprilsingsalot.com for a helpful visual. Let's get to the episode. This is sing-along switch, which means that we're going to be singing and tapping. The theme that we will be singing and tapping around is on letting go. And so a lot of times, something that I struggle with is holding everything that I want like super, super duper tight and being really tense and stressed about things going like exactly the way I need them to go. And that's not healthy. It's something that I work on a regular basis. And so I'm sharing this technique with you in just, you know, on the chance that it's something that you're struggling with as well. I'll just introduce myself really quickly. My name is April, and I'm a mom, a musician, and a military veteran. I live in the U.S. near New Orleans in Louisiana, and I create sing-along style meditations for everyday life. And when I say everyday life, I just mean like the things that we struggle with on the regular. And so hence the theme today around letting go. It's just something that, I wish I could say, hey, this is it. This is the one thing, cure all. You'll never struggle with this again. But it's just like showering. It's something that we have to do on a regular basis. And something that if we're not like constant or consistent in taking care of this, it can sort of take over. And so part of me doing these live series is a way to hold me accountable and make sure that I'm doing the work for myself as well. The first thing that I'm going to do is around releasing control. So it's helpful for us to sort of rate how we are feeling right now. And then once we do this sing-along switch together, we can revisit that and see if it's been helpful. Because not every technique is for everybody. You know, there are plenty of wonderful practices, and sometimes one works better than another. And so this is also a great way for you to see like if this technique is great for you. So I would just invite you to rate this. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being, oh my goodness, I'm so super duper tense. Like for me right now, I'm feeling it in my shoulder. I have a super like something that I'm worried about and it's showing up in my shoulder. But for other people that might be like a knot in your stomach or sometimes like a headache behind your eyes, something like that. So if you're feeling super clenched or stressed, put a number on that. So like 10 would be extreme. 1 would be, I am so chill and I feel awesome. My number, I always ask y'all to share and then I don't share. So I'm going to do that today. Mine would be an 8, I would say. I'm about an 8. But I'll just go ahead and do 2 rounds since there are several of us that are sort of more elevated than expected, I guess. Normally I'm not this tense, but I made the mistake of watching the news and that'll do it to you. Okay, so I'm going to sing each phrase twice. I invite you to sing along. Those that have been here before can probably say this with me. Your voice is very important for you to hear. So please, please sing, if at all possible. Now, the one caveat being if this is painful for you, like definitely singing is one of those things where the adage, like no pain, no gain, that does not apply here. So if it is painful, please do not sing and find someone to help you find someone to help you with that. But as long as you are in good health and able to, I invite you to sing, because you're going to find so much more of a benefit from this. And then I will be tapping as we go, and I invite you to tap along as well. Okay, here we go. Oh, lift me up. Oh, lift me up to a shelter of safety. To a shelter of safety, into the pathway of peace I once knew, into the pathway of peace I once knew. I now release, I now release all my control and planning, all my control and planning into your promises, into your promises, old and yet new, old and yet new. Peace, peace, wonderful peace, 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 wonderful peace, coming down from the heavens above, coming down from the heavens above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray. In fathomless billows of love, in fathomless billows of love. That knot, I can feel that knot in my shoulder is getting a little less tense. So that was definitely helpful for me. We'll do a little more in a little bit, but I just kind of want to gauge how that was. Humming is really good too, because when you're humming, your voice comes forward into your into the mask of your face, and that vibration is really good, really good for loosening up and releasing things. Well, it sounds like this was helpful. So we're on the road, we're on the way. I think I'm about a 6 as well. So I'm definitely it's coming down, but I still need a little, I still need some more, some extra. So we're gonna do this a second singing and tapping, and we're gonna use a different phrase, and it's gonna be the phrase, I deeply and completely love and accept myself. And it'll be that same phrase over and over again as we tap through those points that we just used. And I'm gonna try something different to start with. So in traditional tapping, if you do emotional freedom technique, EFT, or tapping, or if you see this done anywhere else, a lot of times, well, I think I'm the only one that uses this with singing, as far as I know.
But a lot of times when people do it and they're talking, they use what's called a setup statement and start by tapping on the side of your hand, like the karate chop point. And they, let's just say we, okay? So we're gonna start with the karate chop point. And on tapping on this point, we'll say, even though, and then name something that you're tense about right now. Like when we were just singing and used the phrase, I release all my control and planning. Like that's a super triggering phrase for me. So what is it for you? Like what would that be? So mine would be maybe, even though I don't want to release all my control and planning. And then follow it up by, I deeply and completely love and accept myself. So even though there's this thing that I'm not happy about and I know I need to let go of, I still deeply and completely love and accept myself. Like both of those things can be true. I don't have to be perfect in order to deeply and completely love and accept myself, right? We can deeply and completely love and accept ourselves as we are right now. So I'm going to do this three times and I'm going to say in my head what I'm releasing, I'm going to say in my head, even though, and then in my head, I'll say my thing so you can fill it in for yourself and then follow that up by, I deeply and completely love and accept myself. So we'll do that three times. Okay. Even though I deeply and completely love and accept myself, even though I deeply and completely love and accept myself. And one more time, even though I deeply and completely love and accept myself. All right, now we're gonna move to singing and we're gonna go all through the points and we'll sing a couple of rounds of this. I deeply and completely love and accept myself. 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 I deeply accept myself. That was awesome. That was really, I could feel myself unraveling and unclenching as we went through those, points. I'm gonna say I'm at a 3 probably right now. Let's do another round on I deeply and completely love and accept myself. 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 All right. Well, thank you all so much for being here. It's been lovely.
This episode was an excerpt from a live event. If you want to book a session, join the waitlist, or see a visual of the tapping points, head over to aprilsingsalot.com. I'll see you there.